running with quote roughly 15,000 GPUs and their H100. So Grok 2 finished training about a month ago. We're doing what's called fine tuning, fixing bugs and whatnot. So we'll release Grok 2, which will be should be on par with or close to a GPT-4.
Okay.
And that's hopefully we release that next month. Then what we're doing in the Memphis data center is we're actually training Grok 3. So that'll probably finish training in about 3 or 4 months, and then there'll be some fine tuning and bug fixing and whatnot. And we're hoping to release Grok 3 by December. And Grok 3 should be the most powerful AI in the world at that point.
So my sense with ChatGPT, like I've worked with lots of undergraduates and graduate students,
yeah.
So my sense with ChatGPT is if you can corner it into behaving properly, that you kind of have something approximating a team of, I would say, master's degree level intelligence and something like that. What do you envision for this new, well, let's say the new Grok 3? And then you talked about delving deeper into the structure of the universe, let's say, to answer fundamental questions, like, and you are a remarkably forward-looking person. So what the hell do you think you're building with these AI systems? Like, what is this?
Well, I think really what all the AI companies are aiming to build is digital superintelligence. You know, intelligence that's far smarter than any human.
Yeah.
And then ultimately an intelligence that is far smarter than all humans combined. Now one can say, like, is this a wise thing to do? Isn't this dangerous? Well, unfortunately, whether we think that or not, it is being done. From my standpoint, from the XAI team standpoint, we have the choice of being a spectator or a participant.
But that's life, man.
Yeah, be a spectator or a participant. And I think if we're a participant, we've got a better chance, hopefully, of steering AI in a direction that is beneficial to humanity.
So why do you trust yourself on that front? That's an important question, right?
I don't trust myself entirely.
Good. Well, that's yes. Fair enough. Okay.
Yeah.
But you're in an ethical conundrum, right?
Yes, it is an ethical conundrum.
Right, because you said, well, this is happening. Now, the excuse that something is happening is not a rationale for participating in it, but then your next take is, well, you know, we have the chance to do this properly, let's say, as
maybe
opposed
better.
To...
Maybe better.
Okay.
Just pull it. I think we from a moral standpoint, we really just need to think that maybe we've got a chance of it being better.